They're all models.
Which one? The, all of them are models?
No, no, this one's a model of a dog.
But this one is natural.
But this one is... was posed before, we've already been to the Natural History Museum, and it's kind of licking its paw after it kind of thing. And we think that that's kind of where his sort of love for collecting sort of starts when he's at school. So this display really is kind of just introducing the gallery, showing some of the history of Frederick Horniman's collection and collecting. These are some of his around 10,000 insects that he collected of all different kinds, mainly butterflies and beetles, but also other types of insects as well. He wasn't really collecting much of this himself, he wasn't a field collector, he wasn't going out with a butterfly net, and this is all bought specimens from people who did do that at auctions, or were given things by friends and people. And then brought them back, put them on display, and showed them off to his friends. So, again, he wasn't, he left school when he was 14, he didn't spend most of his life working in a scientific capacity, writing papers and articles or that kind of thing. He was running the Horniman TV show very successfully, obviously. So it's quite an interesting and scientifically important connection that we still need to study further. So this entrance to the gallery we redeveloped 3 or 4 years ago now, just to really reframe it for our visitors and explain this is a historic gallery. The displays in the gallery are not necessarily scientifically up to date. They haven't been redisplayed for many decades actually, and they look very similar. So this was the gallery when they are seeing perhaps something.
Looking at the idea again of how there's